Hello everyone, I'm Nikita Kohli, a geopolitical intelligence analyst at Midcat Advisory Services, and I'm back to discuss the COVID-19 numbers and analysis with you. I will be taking the numbers as of 30th of July as are flashing on your screen. Over the next 7 to 8 minutes, I will be discussing how having over 1.5 million cases, but also over 1 million recoveries is affecting the way that the infection is spreading in India and the way we can go forward with it. Looking first at a nationwide analysis, we see that the number of confirmed COVID-19 cases in India has now crossed 1.5 million. With this, we continue to retain the position as the third largest number of infections in the world, behind only the US and Brazil. Despite that, the number of active cases has been declining, and we now have only about 33% active cases in India. The doubling rate in India remains steady at about 20 days, and that is a bit worrying trend since the number has not really moved in the past 2 or 3 weeks. Well, the month of July has also seen an increase in about 175% in cases. The per week infection rate has declined slightly to about 23% in the past week. Number of new cases per day is unfortunately continuously increasing, and we saw the single largest increase on 29th of July with over 54,000 new cases. The entire last week saw close to 50,000 new cases every single week. A worrying trend indeed. Looking at the deaths caused due to COVID-19, we see that India at the moment has roughly 35,000 deaths. That is about 4,500 additional deaths in the past week alone. Despite the number of additional deaths that we're seeing every week, the number of the case fatality rate, that is, has remained quite low at just 2.21%. In the past week, the number has grown by about 700 additional deaths per day. And the month of July in itself saw over 100% increase in deaths due to COVID-19. When you look at the other major trends, we see that once again, as I've been noticing every single week, India has marked the biggest per week increase in cases, with almost 300,000 additional cases being recorded in the week between 23rd and 30th of July. On the positive note, the number of recoveries has also crossed 1 million. As of 30th of July, India had over 1,020,000 recoveries. That is, we have an almost 65% recovery rate. When we look at the testing numbers, we see that we have over 18 million samples which have been tested in total as per ICMR. That is almost 3 million tests which have been done in the past week alone. And when you look at the tests which have been done over the past 24 hours, it's close to 500,000. We see that there's about 150,000 more tests than that were done last week. Despite that, the test positivity rate of India has remained quite high now, which is at 8.7%. But since we're seeing different testing strategies with a lot of states going for contact tracing, the number is quite valid. With this, we will see that the stretching of the curve continues. That is, areas such as Delhi are seeing a decline in cases, while other places like Bangalore and increasingly Chennai are seeing an increase in the number of cases over the past few days. And this continued manner is going to happen over the next few weeks. And with this, you will see some more restrictions being reimposed in a more targeted manner. But as you will see a further increase in cases, we will also see an increase in recoveries as well. Like we noted, the past week has alone seen over 200,000 recoveries across India. But interesting development is happening with the sero surveys which are being done. When we noted last week, the sero surveys in Delhi had shown about 23% of people having developed antibodies to COVID-19. You can also note that Ahmedabad has roughly 1 in 2 people, that is almost 50% of the population, having developed antibodies to COVID-19, which is showing a higher number of infection than previously what we thought of. Mumbai is showing a very interesting trend. While the non-farm block kids are showing about 16% sero survey rate, the slums in Mumbai have shown a drastic 57%, which is very high. But it also shows why we're not seeing as many cases now in the slums as we were a few months back. But as we go forward with Unlock 3, we will see another increase in cases, but that will happen in very particular pockets in the country, and that is where we will see an increase in restrictions as well. When we look at these developments at a more macro level, we see that the top five states of maximum cases, which are Maharashtra, Tamil Nadu, Delhi, Andhra Pradesh, and Karnataka, now contribute to only 63% of all cases in India. This is a major decline from the earlier 75% and then 70% cases that we had been seeing. Despite the decrease in the caseload, we see that these top five states continue to have about 76% of all fatalities. That means that while they are seeing a more number of recoveries as well as fatalities, the caseload is shifting to other states. That is, we will now see a shift in caseload and infections in multiple other states in India. Northeast, for instance, will be one of them, the northeastern region of India, that is. Looking at the major metro cities in India, we continue to see them having a very big caseload amongst all the other cities and towns. That is Delhi, Mumbai, Chennai, Pune, Bangalore, Hyderabad, Ahmedabad, Kolkata, and Gurgaon now contribute to roughly 35% of all COVID cases in India. Two or three states have been seeing an increase in cases. One is Tamil Nadu. Tamil Nadu saw a 160% increase in cases in the month of July. And while it has a very good recovery rate and a decline in active cases, the state has been seeing roughly 7,000 new cases per day in just last week. This has become a major cause of concern, and that is why we are seeing an increase in the restrictions which are being imposed in the state. Karnataka continues to perform very poorly, and the state noted a 640% almost increase in cases in July, with almost 40% of these increases taking place in the last week alone. It has almost 60% active cases and a very poor recovery rate of just 40%. The state capital, that's Bengaluru, accounts for almost half of all cases in the state and has the worst performing metrics of all the metro cities in India. Bengaluru has over 70% active cases, there's 26% recoveries, and a massive, massive increase of over 1,030% in COVID-19 infections in July alone. Andhra Pradesh is also seeing a steep increase in cases, and it has over 724% increase in cases in July, but and has more than 50% active caseload. Andhra Pradesh is going to suddenly start showing more cases, but just since we do not have the other metrics of the state, which the state government has not been releasing, we will find it difficult to understand the developments which are happening over there. But as we continue and certain number of recoveries increasing, we need to still be very, very cautious as we move along. As we're seeing with the sero surveys, more and more people are getting infected than we have previously thought of before. It is now the time to continue wearing your face mask and maintaining social distance at all times, especially in offices. This is a place where you don't have as much control over meeting different people. So if you're going to be starting the offices, please get back in touch with us to know what are the different CAPA measures and SOPs that you need to put in place to be able to restart your offices in a very safe manner. Until then, take care and goodbye.